On the trail of the earliest people learning goals, life of hunter-gatherer, the Stone Age climate change discovery of fire, life of hunter-gatherer, the primitive man was a hunter-gatherer. He used to hunt animals and gather fruits and other plant produce for food. The early man did not live at one place, rather used to move from one place to another. This means that the early man lived a nomadic life. Reasons of nomadic life: the food resource at a particular place was exhausted after some time. Hence, people were forced to move in search of a better place. Moving from one place to another was also important for hunting. We know that animals also keep on moving from one place to another. Most of the plants are seasonal. They bear fruits or seeds in a particular season. So, to get constant supply of fruits, roots, seeds, etc., people needed to be on move. People also needed to move in search of water. You know that some rivers and ponds become dry during summer. The Stone Age, you have read that hunter-gatherers lived during the prehistoric period. People in this age used stones for making tools. Due to this, this period is also called the Stone Age. The Stone Age is divided into three phases: A. Paleolithic or Old Stone Age, B. Mesolithic or Middle Stone Age, C. Neolithic or New Stone Age. Paleolithic Age. The term Paleolithic is made up of two Greek words, paleo and lithos. The term paleo means old and the term lithos means stone. Hence, this period is also called the Old Stone Age. This period extends from 2 million years ago to 12,000 years ago. The tools from this period were crude and had no refinement. The tools in this figure were made about 10,000 years ago. These are much smaller and show better design. These tools are from the Mesolithic Age. Apart from stones, bones and wood were also used for making tools and for many other purposes. What is remarkable about stone tools is that some of them are being still used in modern homes. For example, grinding stone is still used in many homes for grinding spices and for making flour. Uses of stone tools: for cutting meat and bones, for scraping bark from trees and hide from animals, for chopping fruits and roots. Some tools were attached to handles, made of wood or bone, to be used as axe or hammer. The earliest people climate change. You will be surprised to know that a major part of the Stone Age was during the Ice Age. Ice was all around and there was negligible vegetation on the Earth. After global warming, the Ice Age came to an end about 12,000 years ago. End of the Ice Age meant clearance of a vast tract of land. This also meant an ambient temperature for the growth of plants. More green plants resulted in better availability of food for animals and humans. This was the period when many modern-day mammals must have proliferated. More animals meant better availability of meat. After the Ice Age, the plants of the grass family began to grow in most parts of the world. You must be aware that rice, wheat, and corn belong to the grass family. It means that a major portion of our food comes from the grass family. This was the period when people may have started using cereals and grains. Where did people live? This map of India shows some important sites where people lived during the Stone Age. Some major places where people lived during the Old Stone Age are: A. Bimbetka, Madhya Pradesh; B. Hunsky, Karnataka; C. Kurnool Caves, Andhra Pradesh. Two common factors for these sites are as follows: I. These places are near a river. The presence of a river means that availability of water was not an issue. E. These places are somewhere in the Deccan Plateau. The Deccan Plateau has plenty of stones. Thus, the materials for making stone tools were available in plenty. Factory sites, places where people could get plenty of stones for making tools, were used as sites for making the tools. Such places are called factory sites. At some places, people also lived at such factory sites. Such sites are called habitation cum factory sites. Proofs for factory sites. Historians have found many proofs at factory sites. They have found much larger stones and some unfinished tools. These proofs show that these were the locations of factory sites. Blank underscore blank making stone tools. Historians have made guesses about the possible methods of making stone tools. There were two possible methods of making stone tools. They are as follows: A. Stone on stone. In this method, a stone was taken in one hand and was hit with another stone to make a particular shape. The stone which was made into a tool was called the core. B. Pressure flaking. In this method, the core was kept on a hard surface. It was then hammered with a bigger stone to make a particular shape. Discovery of fire. The discovery of fire was a major revolution for the human beings. It changed the human life dramatically. People may have learned to use fire after seeing the effects of forest fire. A person may have accidentally dropped a piece of meat in fire and may have tasted the cooked meat for the first time. People may have learned to produce fire by rubbing two stones together. Historians have found traces of ash from Kurnool caves. This suggests that fire was used by the people who lived in these caves. Fire could be used for many purposes. Fire can be used for clearing forest. It can be used for cooking. Fire could be used for keeping the wild animals away from human dwellings. Rock paintings. The people of the Stone Age were very good artists as well. Many cave paintings have been found in the cave dwellings of the Stone Age. For example, the caves in Bimbetka show beautiful paintings. Most of the paintings show animals and hunting scenes. Historians believe that these paintings may have been made as a part of a ritual. People may have made those drawings before going for hunting. Another possibility is that people must have got enough spare time to think about the beautiful nature around them. These paintings also show that people used to live as a community. Living with the herd has many benefits. A large group provided better protection against predators. A group could easily kill a big animal. This ensured the supply of plenty of food. Historians guess that usually men went for hunting, while women lived in caves to take care of children. Women may have focused on collecting fruits, roots, and berries.